It has a little like whoosh. Nope, that doesn't look right. Greetings and salutations. Hey girl, hey, what is up? Today we're gonna be doing TikTok makeup filters, pick my makeup. I'm sure you've seen at least one or two videos of different filters that help with placement of products. So there's like a contour one, an eyebrow one, there's a picking your lipstick one, and then one that randomizes eyeliners, and some of them are kind of unique, I should say. I am excited and a little nervous, but depending on how our brows and our liner goes, we may wear test something else in a separate video today, or we may just be doing this together. Regardless, I think we're gonna have a lot of fun, so let's get started. So I'm gonna try to take a little bit of a screen recording so you can see what I see without me having to do this. We're gonna start with our eyebrows. I'm a big fan of this filter. I think it's great just as a guideline because the filters adapt to where your, you know, facial structures are. And for the most part, my brows are actually placed pretty well because it's very similar to what my brow tech does when we use like string and ink to map out my brows when we do our tattooing. Most of you guys know, and if you don't know, I've removed a lot of my microblading because I'm gonna do some nanoblading instead, and I'm gonna change my arch. And that's mainly what you can see different in the filter, is that my arch is right here, like it's a little bit lower than we want it, and that's mainly what we're changing. We're kind of extending it this way, but we originally just followed where my brows grew because my brows grow that way, and I've just kind of given up on that part where I'm just like, I'll just pluck and remove just this little tail and bring it this way instead because it's a little bit more flattering for my eye shape. So a lot of people have just been marking where they need to go with a brow product, but my inner corners are already correct, which is awesome. We did move my inner corners in with my tattooing because my hair kind of stops a little short, as you can see by this bare spot right here. But symmetry wise, it makes sense to bring them in a little closer. It looks good on some people. I'm gonna use a little bit of more of an ink based product, which is the Hailey Beauty Redefine, and I'm just gonna place this where it's advising us to end our brows, which is right here. Okay, and then just about right there as well. This brow I flex a lot, but maybe we'll move it down just a click. But the arch is already correct and the inner corners are already correct, so we don't need too much of a guideline there. So I haven't gelled anything, I haven't concealed anything. These are just what my brows look like straight up. They've been laminated, but they haven't been brushed, so when I brush them up, they look a lot fluffier. I really wish I had lamination when I was younger, just because I think what I had to work with was a lot more flattering lifted. So to hold that lifted look, I use the Refi gel. This is my daily. If I really need to, I break out something a little bit more heavy duty, but this works really well for me. So I'm gonna just brush it through the brows first before we fill them in. I get a lot of questions about how many like removal sessions I did for my microblading. So I let them fade for a year, did one lasering session and then three saline sessions. We have a little bit of a tone correction for this redness, like a little olive session, and then we should be nanoblading them back, but it's been basically like a whole year. This is just the top part of the applicator of the product. I use this to slick them up and over just like that, and then this side. Gotta work kind of quick with this product, but I have reviewed it separately and I did a compare and contrast with Makeup by Mario gel, which I think is so heavy duty. Check that out if you'd like. Honestly, within this last year, I feel like I've improved my brow game so much. I mean, there was like definitely some dark periods where like the hairs weren't functioning or the hairs were still recovering from some of the removals, but I definitely feel more confident with my brow skills, and I think this filter really helps guide people to you get it yourself. So let's focus on the tails first, because that's what I usually would like to do. In strong debate whether I want to use more of an ink based or a pencil based, but let's just start with the pencil base because I feel like that's the safer bet. This is Too Faced Super Fine Brow Definer in medium brown. If there's a medium brown, I typically will be using it. So that's where our tail is gonna end. The arch is already correct, so we're gonna connect that down just like that, and I'll be concealing whatever's not supposed to be there. Same thing over here. That's our end. I can just relax my eyebrow. I think the arch is a little high. There we go. Filters like this make me realize how much more space I have on one side of my nose to like the end of my face than the other, which, you know, is a very common thing, but you don't see it until you try to make your face even. Just drawing my outline out. This one might need to be extended just a little bit to match the other side. And now the majority of my brows is gonna be filled in with Makeup by Mario's Light Brunette Master Blade Pencil. It has like a box cutter type of vibe. Mm-hmm. This is what I like to use on my inner corners because it's so natural. We're just following where my microblading ends. We only removed my inner corners mainly because we wanted some like nice, fresh, fluffy strokes because obviously my brows were originally tattooed in 2015. So I had different hair there, different preferences. Now I'm just more of that like, give me a natural fluff front, and we wanted as much of a clean canvas as possible. I'm really excited because nanoblading supposedly is, you know, way more comfortable because the blade is smaller, way more natural. Not that I didn't like my brows, but you know, times change. And I'm still going through my same brow tech. We did all our removals together and then we'll be putting them back on. She's my girl. And I will link her off down below if you're in the DC area. Just like that. It's pretty simple. A little bit of Hailey Beauty's Rewind. I know we're all looking at the dot that I put, so we're gonna try to rub it off, then just fill that brow part back in because it is from a waterproof, smudge-proof brow product, so it's not like, it's not gonna take off some of the stuff underneath as well, but there we go. We got our guideline. Ooh, right, same thing. Sometimes I'll take whatever I have left and kind of rub it on the very inner corners just in case I want a little bit more of like a fade, but not too much, whatever's kind of left on the brush. Got this one hair that just doesn't want to go in the clip and it doesn't want to get out the way. So I have this little part on this eyebrow right here where I feel like the muscle is so defined because it's always so flexed when I talk. Like it's like bulky, you know, it has gains. I tend to try to figure out after the product's on like how much I want to take away from the top of my arch or fill in right next to it. I'm gonna gently just fill in right here to make it just a little bit more even. But it's such a subtle change. So that is what our brows look like. Let's double check our filter. Let's see, relaxing eyebrows. This part right here is just a little bit off the line, just a little. And then this side has just a little under where it's supposed to have. Same right here, none of this. So it's advising me to fill in just a little bit more right here, just to look a little bit straighter, a little less arch. No problem, I just don't have any hair there. So there we go, this side's right. This side needs a little bit more there. And then I guess I can just clean it up a little. It's kind of hard, I really don't have hair there, but I mean, this is close enough. This looks pretty good. That's kind of how I've been trying to fill in my brows, but this gives me like that, like, okay, this is as even as it gets. I really like this one. So if you're looking for it, it's just called Eyebrows and it's created by Grace M. Choi. So next up would be our eyeliner. So I think this is gonna be really fun. Last time I tried this, so I tried this last week and it actually went pretty cool. I had some pretty cool graphic liner on and I think I saved the screenshot, but I don't know, the rest of the video, like the energy just wasn't there. I don't know, like I was rushing or something. I don't know what was going on, but I wasn't feeling it. So ultimately I was like, all right, we're redoing that after, you know, I finish some other things. Also, I found more filters for us to try, so it worked out. So I'm gonna just apply concealer across my lid and a little bit of translucent powder. And honestly, I don't really need much since this is a cream to powder finish, but a little bit wouldn't hurt. This is also Hailey Beauty. This is the Retouch Transparent Translucent Loose Powder. It's going a little bit across. So we have an even base. There's like a very minor dot from where we marked, but it's so smudge proof, it's not worth scraping off skin. So we're gonna move on. So we're gonna do our eyeliner now. The filter is from TT Dedemare. I don't know if I'm saying that right at all, but it's gonna let us know right now. This one's kind of unique. Okay, a vibe. So what I'm gonna do, I screenshotted it just in case. I have three liquid liners picked out. I don't know which one. So most pigmented is definitely the one size. I have a NYX Epic ink liner as well. And then I have Makeup by Mario's, which is also another felt tip. So two felt tips and one brush tip. I'm gonna start with the brush tip. I feel like this will help me have a little bit more control. It's a smaller applicator. I'm gonna put little marks. So it wants something right here and right here. That's the starting point for there. And then obviously the outer corner to here, there, there. Okay, got a little guideline. And this part needs to start here. Off by a little bit, okay. All right, those are our guide points, roughly. Let's see if we can do this. All right, so this should be easy enough where it's just a wing to here. Could be a better line, but there we are. Line, and then to right above the crease. Okay, these need to be super straight, so I'm gonna bring out an oldie but goodie, the liner designer. Oh, it has a lash on it. Ew. From Beauty Blender, because it has a really nice straight edge. It's silicone. Okay, you gotta be straight, girl. Oh god, my under eyes are too wrinkly. That didn't work out. We're gonna redo that. I'm gonna probably need to switch to a different liner for that part. My under eye has a lot of skin. Okay, but it was roughly right here. So at least I have that mark. All right, let's switch to the one size liner. Ooh, this tip is a little intimidating. How do I do this? Did I do it? No. I'm like just trying to like stamp this down now. Oh my God. We might have to touch it up, but it's a lot of skin. There's a lot of skin. It's not the tightest skin. So this has a little bit of a wave to it. So it's a little like this and then this. It has a little like whoosh. Nope, that doesn't look right. Honestly, the last time I did this, the liner was a lot bolder, but I kind of liked it a little bit more because it was something, you know what I mean? I feel like this one's gonna be a little lackluster at the end of it. I'm switching liners like it's my job. So that's kind of what it looks like on the thing to me. I mean, it's a little bit more wavy on my eyes, whatever. It's closer to this than this one. This is supposed to be really sleek and thin. Even when I let go of my eye skin, it's like, no, no, we're not. All right, let's try to clean up that liner a little bit, but they look a little different. This one needs to be pieced together. I feel like these are supposed to be so narrow and so straight, but the more I talk, the more straight it's not. I just talk like Yoda. The more it isn't straight, I look like a sad clown, right? A sad clown. So maybe not this. TikTok, maybe not this one. Let's see if we get anything better. All right, let's wipe off the tears of a clown. It's really giving, this is why we don't have any other makeup on our face. Let's try the filter one more time. All right. This one's a little bit better. Like you have to ignore the other marks I had. And it kind of works with what we already have. So we'd be using these and bringing it in. So maybe we can do a little of that. So I don't know, like, is this really a look? And honestly, I kind of want it to be a little bit, not wearable, but like flattering to my eye shape. So maybe we'll go a little less thick, but still follow the same pattern because I don't think it's taking into account how droopy it's gonna make my eyes. This Mario liner is crazy pigmented. I forgot how pigmented it is. We're gonna have to clear that top piece a little bit, but this eye's okay, but my inner corners like are really hard for me to navigate. I can't really reach it with my nails. And I also hate doing like inner corner liner because I can't ever get the angle right. It's just something that never looks good with my eyelids. So we're trying our best right now. That's all we can do is try our best. This is exhausting enough that I'm like, yeah, a wear test is happening a different day because we're not going around like this all day. It's a no from me. Yeah, it's a little messy. There's like a lot of removal marks, a lot of smudges. They're actually quite similar right now because when I open my eyelids, they're almost exactly the same. Maybe this is supposed to be just a little bit rounder right there. A little rounder, just like that. And then this has a little not smooth area. I think that's that might be that for there. I don't know. We're trying to sharpen it out even though it wasn't super sharp. I think sharper looks better. It's not getting any sharper, okay. Was it worth the struggle? I don't really know. It's giving like a little bit of like e-girl, a little e-girl, nothing wrong with that. We might need a lash, don't you think? I feel like we need a big lash, like a long lash. These are from the Dollar Tree, Ioni lashes. These are Wispy Doll Full. I have one side trim from when I did my Dollar Tree try on. Let's see, rough place. Yeah, we might have to go like full like e-girl right now. We're not wear testing, so let's just take it there. I'm gonna use a little bit of Velour's liner. I glue, it's like their line and go, but, or lash and go, I believe it's called. But since we already have a really thick liner, I'm just gonna put it on the lash since I don't know where we're placing it yet. And now for the other side, I just trimmed it down. I think it's gonna look a lot better once we curl it as well. Can we talk about how much time this would have saved me in high school if I had a liner that was also a lash glue? That would have been everything and more. I didn't wear lashes at school, and that was mainly because I was just fumbling around with my duo and it wasn't a pretty sight. This one's sitting so differently. This one like kind of just fell into place. Well, this one is not sure where it wants to go. I think it's gonna flip up when we curl it, so it's a little more confused on that eye. Here we go. A little bend and snap. The funniest part is that my natural lashes aren't that tall. So it's like, even at its curliest, it's like, where do you want us to go? You want us to hang out with what? We got a little lash hair that has no clue where it's going. You can see like the gap. Cause yes, you could totally like bind it together with some mascara. But I don't think I can't reach my lashes at all with how high up these are actually placed. Ooh, it's weird. It looks like I have like three lines of lashes. Let me try to fill in the in-between. Solution being, if you applied like lower to the lash line, it wouldn't have that issue, but I don't think it would sit right on my eyes if I applied any lower and my lashes said, we are not conforming to this. Absolutely not. If I was really going out, I would probably take some of my Falscara glue and like stick them together like this and do a whole thing. I don't think it's worth it for the amount of time I'm probably keeping this on today, because that's a lot of commitment. What a look. So we're gonna move on to the contour filter, which is basically gonna have us contouring up here. That is a lot. I think we're gonna use the Patrick Ta She's Sculpted today, the cream side, and if we need to, you know, we could do a little powder as well. Usually you use the powder first on that product. And I also have the Charlotte Tilbury Flawless Filter. This is in 3 light medium. I figured maybe since we're not really needing a base, we could do this on the parts that aren't contoured and see if that gives us a cute little dimension. I also have some other Charlotte Tilbury's on standby. And for blush, I wanna use the M Cosmetics Peachy Peach. So as you guys can see from the contour, it wants us to contour from here to here. Like that's high, because you know we used to be down here and now we here, but we're going up here. So there's this little gap for contour, highlight, and blush right here. I get what they're going for. It's really gonna elongate the face. I have a really oval face, so it's gonna do something up here. It might not do anything for down here. Like we're definitely gonna be like whoo. And could be really flattering, might be a disaster. We'll find out together. I'm gonna be using this Rare Beauty brush. I also have the Patrick Ta one, but that one's a little large. This is very similar. So just right here and then kind of tapering down. My face is a little longer than this filter thinks it is, or maybe shorter because it's all up in my hairline. So those are our placements. Let's really perfect it now. This is a brush with nothing on it, and I'm gonna use it to lightly layer. Oh, we're getting a little far off. Just right here. Suspicious. I'm gonna try to follow a similar angle in my chin contour. So if we're going here, then we'd be like this, which is something I kind of already do. But I usually wrap it down underneath a little bit more. Same thing on this side. Make sure that double chin hides a little bit. I like it really nice and pointy. I'm trying to make sure this contour is at least opaque at some point. I really wish they gave one for the nose, to be honest. They give a line straight down, which is like where you would highlight, but the brow one seems a little bit more nose focused, to be honest, because it goes from this line down. But see, I don't have a problem with definition up there. I have a problem with definition down here. Some people are doing more of a triangle. Some people are coming down straight. I don't know. Following the center line that's in this filter right now. That at least looks like something, right? Like, hey. Kind of just darkening everything that isn't in that little center line. So when we do our highlight and our under eye concealer, we have something to work with. It's a little crooked looking at the top. Maybe I'll flip this way. This eyebrow ended a little too early. Yeah, it's definitely crooked. I lined up with my dot, which is aligned wrong. My dot is off center to the left. Oh well. All right, so let's do a little highlighting, shall we? So a little underneath to make sure that's nice and sharp. Kind of fill in that space between. And then a little right here. Make sure that part gets what it needs out of me. There we are. All right, we're gonna use a sponge. So everyone adores this product. Some people put it under things, some people wear it alone, some people wear it as a highlight. I haven't actually found a way to make it work for me, so it hasn't been my favorite throughout the few years I've had it, or year. That sounds kind of gross, but I swear I haven't had it that long. I just know I didn't get it this year. So this is my Hailey Beauty Concealer. Definitely a brighter, oh God, I got on my eyeliner. A brighter situation. Not fully blending it out with this brush. Kind of doing more of a placement. I think I want to use this down my nose too. Maybe we can correct it a little bit. It's a little bit more straight. So then this will be on the other parts of our forehead, and we'll kind of surround it with a little contour. That bridge is snatched. I don't care what you guys say. That bridge is snatched. The rest of it, etched, not snatched. But you know, it's definitely a skinnier starting point. A little bit of the Hollywood Falls filter just on the top of the bridge. Put a little bit on the center of my eyelids to brighten up the other side. We're almost there, guys. We're working on it. A little bit of this blush just above our contour, which was right here, I believe. adding a little bit with my fingers. I feel like the brush kind of took it away. Really so high up my cheekbone, it's the weirdest feeling. Last but not least, I've seen people do this on TikTok. This is so weird. We're highlighting all the way up here, like right here. Just blending that out. This is the Glowgasm from Chartels. I'm trying to get these angles right. That part's really pretty though. Ooh. So as long as this concealer stays nice and flat, gives us that dimension in the center. Mm-hmm. Our inner corner liners are just like, what? Last but not least, lips. There's a lipstick randomizer. So we're gonna zoom on in. All right. Oh, it gives a little pop to the eyes too. It kind of just looks like my lips. Okay. Pouty, blotty. Trying to see what I have. Nope, that's too pink. Maybe this? This is e.l.f.'s Sheer Slick in Golden Pear, but it was a little bit more red than this. So I think I'm gonna go over it with a blush. I have Joy from Rare Beauty. That's giving more coral. I just thought about it. I think I know what it looks like. So this looks a lot like Rare Beauty's Brave. It's a little deeper, so maybe we put a lip liner underneath, or no, this will do. I put a light layer so some of my natural lip color can kind of shine through, and just patting the edges. Excuse my dry ass lips. It's a little deeper than that, but not by too much. It's interesting because the filter changes as you apply things. Since we're here, I'm gonna put a little of this ColourPop Color Duo. I actually opened the white one, and the white side just like blew out. This is peachy. Kind of hug that inner corner liner a little bit. I'm feeling a little ooh-ooh-ish a little bit. Imagine if I have like little spikes coming down right here. It's very like, ooh, you know? So what are we thinking? What are we thinking? Do we like how our contour ended up today, guys? I think the highlight positioning, a little higher than we usually are. Like, we're usually right here, but bringing it up. I've always liked to kind of bring it up and connect it to the brow. So that I'm on board with. The contour without the hair clips in, what do we think? I don't really think it's doing much for us. Like, I see where it was trying to do it, but I really think here is still a little better for the cheekbones and the shape. And I have really, you know, thick jaw muscles, all these situations, real, real strong for my TMJ. So I don't know. Some days like it's real bulky because it's swollen. Today's not a bad day, but I don't think this would flatter me on any day. So the contour is probably a no for me. I saw it looking on so many people. I'll try to keep the blush and the highlighter, hello, placement better than the contour. I kind of like our nose today a little bit. And I think that worked out because of how much concealer I had on our lids already. Kind of helped correct where my actual crevice is. The liner isn't that bad. I think the one we had earlier was kind of boring. Dare I say boring? Dare I say it would probably look better in like a neon color? This is okay. Average. Average. I'm not like, ooh, I've never looked better. I love the brow filter. A plus for that. It is absolutely my favorite. The lipstick one's obviously just fun. And the eyeliner one can be fun. I've seen really, really pretty looks on different lids. But I don't know how much it really takes into account in your lids. So that's that. If you've tried any of these filters, go ahead and let me know which one down below was your favorite to use on yourself and which one was the favorite you saw today on me. I would love to hear. Let's put a cell phone emoji if we've made it this far. If you've made it to the end, because I know this was such a video. Thank you guys so much for tuning in to another episode of my TikTok series. I've tried a bunch of products they've recommended. I've bought like home related items they've recommended. We've done a lot with Miss TikTok. TikTok is honestly like, whew, like pros and cons. Cons takes up way too much of my time for sure. Like if I deleted the app, I'm sure I'd have so much more free time. Pro is we get to do fun things like this, and obviously I get to see a lot of your product requests and recommendations and new things that are out. So that plus really cute puppies. I mean, it's staying on my phone. It's staying on my phone, just like. If you're interested in seeing the other episodes of my series, I will have the playlist linked off down below. Thank you guys again for watching and spending part of your day with me. I hope you guys enjoyed seeing the chaos that is me trying something new, but growth only comes from being out of your comfort zone. Remember that. Remember that. Uncomfortability means you're growing. That is it for me today. I will put my recent uploads on the screen right now, as well as the subscribe button. So if you would like to subscribe, you can do so. It is free 99, and we'd love to have you join our fam. I will see you guys in a later video.